Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson, and one of my most popular video series that I've created has been my budget video editing PC build guides, with the latest one that I just uploaded showing you how to build a budget 4K video editing PC for $650. But what if you have a budget larger than $650? What if you need to edit 4K video, but it's raw, or 6K video, or 8K, or something like that? Well, today I have good news for you because I'm going to be showing you how to build a very powerful video editing computer for $1,400. And in addition, I also want to show you some upgrades for these parts that are going to increase the cost but also have the potential to drastically increase the speed of your video editing. So whether you use Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve or really any other video editing software, as long as it isn't Final Cut, which is Mac only, you are going to be set with this computer. And as a side note, if you're looking for a computer to edit photos or mix music or game or live stream, this computer is going to be perfect for all of that. There are two quick things that we need to talk about before we get into the parts for this build. First, all of the parts will be linked down in the video description, and they will also be on my kit page where they are neatly organized for you to check out. Second, this video is only going to show you the parts that you need to buy, not how to put them together. But do not worry, I made a video a while back that's over an hour long showing you every single step that you need to take to build a video editing computer. From taking the parts out of the box to turning on the computer, everything is covered, and you can watch that video up in the corner and down in the description after you purchase your parts. Now let's jump right into this $1,400 video editing PC build. And the first part that I want to cover is the CPU, aka the brain of the computer. And having a fast CPU is so important because if you can get a CPU with a lot of cores and a lot of threads, your video editing experience is going to be so much faster. I would recommend purchasing the Ryzen 7 3700X processor, which has 8 cores and 12 threads for quite a reasonable price of around $330. This is from AMD's latest generation of processors, and in my opinion, it is in the sweet spot of power to performance. But I hear you saying, Matt, price to performance, sweet spot, that sounds great, but what else you got? You got something with more power for me that won't break the bank? I do. If you have an extra $170-ish dollars, I would go with the AMD Ryzen 9 3900X processor, which is going to take you from 8 cores and 16 threads to 12 cores and 24 threads of performance. This is nuts and should be able to handle 4K, 6K, 8K, all the Ks of video that you want to throw at it. Now let's talk about cooling for both of these CPUs. The great news is that both the 3700X and 3900X both come with a stock air cooler in the box to keep the CPU cool. In all my research, it looks like this is a good cooler, so I would save your money on buying an aftermarket option. But if you notice your computer's running a bit warm, I will link to other cooling options down in the description that you could use to cool your CPU. Moving on, let's talk about the motherboard. The board that you're gonna put the CPU, graphics card, RAM, etc. onto. I would recommend purchasing the MSI X570 Gaming Plus motherboard, which currently retails for around $170. This motherboard has nearly all of the features you will need, with lots of room to upgrade in the future. The only feature it doesn't have is built-in Wi-Fi, but don't worry, you can purchase either an internal or an external Wi-Fi adapter for $20 to $30. I will link to the Wi-Fi adapters I recommend down in the video description. If you really want Wi-Fi built in though, and don't want to deal with putting in a Wi-Fi card or using one of your USB ports with a Wi-Fi adapter, I would recommend purchasing the MSI MPG X570 Gaming Edge Wi-Fi motherboard. This motherboard is very similar to the one I recommended, but it does have built-in Wi-Fi. Please keep in mind that there are cheaper motherboards out there, but a lot of them came out before AMD's latest version of processors that I'm recommending that you use. And the issue with these earlier motherboards is that if you want to use them with one of AMD's newer CPUs that I'm recommending, you are going to have to upgrade the firmware for the motherboards, which requires you to have another CPU, which you're not gonna have. So it's a lot of hassle, but that's why I'm recommending these motherboards, because they should work flawlessly with the CPUs that I'm recommending. Now let's talk about RAM. No, not goats. You do not need any goats to build a computer. RAM, aka memory. This is what your computer is going to need to run your programs. Don't confuse RAM with your SSD though, which we will talk about in a minute. For RAM, I would recommend purchasing a minimum of 32 gigabytes of Corsair Vengeance LPX RAM at 3200 megahertz. I had 32 gigabytes of RAM in my editing desktop for years, and it was enough to handle 4K footage. I want you to be aware though that I did notice that my computer was starting to run out of RAM when I was editing and rendering higher resolution footage. It would also run out of RAM when I rendered 4K videos that were longer. Think 20 minutes or more in length. To prevent yourself from running out of RAM, I would purchase 64 gigabytes of Corsair Vengeance LPX RAM at 3200 megahertz instead. That should be plenty for your needs, but do keep in mind that the two motherboards I recommended to you both support up to 128 gigabytes of RAM, so you have even more room if you want to upgrade. Next, you have your SSD. This is going to store your operating system, as well as any programs that you want to run on your computer. The best price to size and performance option is going to come from Samsung, with their 500 gigabyte 970 Evo Plus for about $120. If you need more space and have the budget though, I would recommend upgrading to the 1 terabyte version of this drive. Extra space is always a good thing. Please keep in mind that for the fastest video editing experience, I recommend only using this SSD to store your operating system and programs. Don't keep your video editing files on it. Because I travel a lot, if you travel as well, I would recommend investing in an external hard drive or SSD. The good news is that the computer case that I recommend can also take internal hard drives and internal SSDs. And so I will make sure to link to, down in the description, all of the internal and external hard drives and SSDs that I would recommend that you purchase with this build. It's now time to talk about one of the most exciting parts of any computer build, the graphics card. If you edit in Premiere Pro and don't oftentimes find yourself applying a lot of video effects that are accelerated by the graphics card, then I would purchase the NVIDIA EVGA RTX 2060 Super SC Ultra Gaming Graphics Card. I recommend this card because Premiere still prioritizes using your computer's CPU over the GPU, so saving a bit of money on the graphics card makes sense. As I said though, you have two options. If you edit using DaVinci Resolve, or if you use Premiere Pro with a lot of graphic effects applied, both of these usage scenarios will benefit from you using a higher-end graphics card. So I would recommend the NVIDIA EVGA RTX 2080 Super Black Gaming Card. This is going to be a noticeable bump in performance for also a noticeable bump in price, so please be aware. I would also recommend upgrading your CPU from the 3700X to the 3900X before upgrading your graphics card to the higher-end version that I recommend. Almost finished with this build. We only need to talk about the power supply and the case. Let's start with the case that you're gonna put all of these parts inside. I'm actually gonna recommend that you buy the same case that I recommended in my budget build video, the NZXT H510. It's a beautiful case that doesn't look too flashy, and when I'm building a computer, I've learned that I would rather spend my money on a cheaper case with good airflow and save the rest for components inside the case. If you wanna go crazy though, there are a lot more options out there that are more expensive that look really cool. I'm also aware that there are some of you out there that want to have a case that has an internal 5.25 inch drive bay so you can install a DVD or Blu-ray burner. Personally, I would rather purchase an external USB, Blu-ray, or DVD drive. I will make sure to link to the ones that I recommend down in the video description. But if you want a case that can handle an internal optical drive, I would recommend the Fantex Enthu Pro MTG ATX mid-tower case. This will run a bit more expensive than the NZXT H510, but it's a great choice that looks very professional. Very last thing, let's talk about the power supply, which is going to power this computer. If you are just buying the $1,400 version of this computer with none of the upgrades, then I think you'll have plenty of power with the EVGA Supernova G3 550 watt power supply. But if you are buying any of the upgrades or even the alternative case option because you want to use a Blu-ray drive, I would recommend purchasing the EVGA Supernova G3 750 watt power supply instead. I've done some calculations and there are certain scenarios where the 550 watt version may not give you enough power. And I wanna make sure that you have some wiggle room to plug in 5 hard drives of footage and other accessories like I tend to do with my computer. With the power supply chosen, congratulations! This is your $1,400 video editing computer. I'm sure some of you are thinking now, Matt, there's other things. What about the mouse, the keyboard, the speakers, the monitor, help? Do not worry, I realize that everybody has a different opinion about these things, but I will link to all of those physical accessories that I recommend down in the video description. And because this computer is made to edit 4K and higher resolution footage, I would definitely recommend investing in a 4K monitor like the one that I recommend. As far as the operating system goes, I would recommend Windows 10. And I have a link down in the video description to a Tom's Hardware article that details how you can get Windows 10 for very cheap or even free. With that, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video is helpful to you with building a monstrous 4K video editing computer. As always, it would be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more videos like this in the future. Please also keep in mind that the prices for these parts are also subject to change, even from day to day. So if you click on one of these links and the part price looks crazy expensive or it's out of stock, please leave me a comment down below and let me know so I can update the link both in the description and on my kit page with a properly priced part that is actually in stock. Lastly, if you made it this far in the video and you're thinking, Matt, this computer is way too expensive, remember, I have that budget $650 video editing PC video that's linked up in the corner and down in the description if you want to watch it. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.